Seriously, yes, we are assured that it reads perfectly.
Mm-hmm. For the national single space
and the party list. Mm-hmm. Wow, what a waste of space that is.
That's true.
There it is. Mm-hmm. What can you do?
Of course, Ben-Hur Abalos saying that you need all the standard election paraphernalia for
a
manual count. The tally sheet.
That's correct. And there are only enough for 30 million for ERs. And he's right. What do you do when you overvote? He says you ignore the last one. Well, you can also do it
in the manual
with
count.
with the shading. Mm-hmm. So you just take the first. So many names, and if you shaded more than the required number, then you ignore the last one.
But that is if we have a manual count for the local.
Yeah,
because right now in the Picos machines, they invalidate the entire position if you overvote.
That's rather worse. Mm-hmm. I mean, for you.
So what other surprises do you expect or do you anticipate?
That's what I asked them. I said, look. Gus Lagman couldn't figure out that something like this could happen after talking
that he has been talking.
But on the other hand, neither did Smartmatic. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And then it turns out that Smartmatic was rather frank, and he said, yeah, and to think this happened in the States. So we all looked at Smartmatic. It happened in the States? Yes, it did. It wasn't our company, but it was. Uh-huh. Yeah, but it happened. Mm-hmm. So somebody should have thought that you don't monkey with the design. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So it was also the double space, single space.
Mm. So again, are they anticipating any other problems with the other aspects of the automation?
They think it's okay. Mm. Yeah.
But transmission is still a big
still a problem.
Right now.
There's 30% of the geographical, but not the population areas. I mean, not the density of population still need satellites. Mm-hmm. So, but still, it's still faster than the old trudging with the ballot box.
True.
Mm. Yeah, I hope so.
Komalek said it should prepare for 30% manual elections. With this development, it's going to be more than that.
I don't know if they said that they would prepare 30%. They said that they would have problems with communication with 30% geographically, 30% of the country, which only means that you bring the flashcard to some other area to transmit.
I think to the municipal where the municipal canvas is being held.
I have friends in ARM who will insist that it be done electronically. You just don't trust manual. Let's just move it to the next barangay.
Okay, because you know, in the internet, the Twitter sphere and the Facebook
blogosphere,
Facebook, you know, everybody, it's abuzz with all this talk about.
Oh, yeah.
Here we go. You know, the failure of machines, and this is going to be like a failure of elections. Not a failure of elections.
It cannot be a failure of elections because you have
the
physical.
True.
Yeah, yeah.
But it'll be. It could be a delayed election. I mean, a delayed results, but not apparently. Not for national. That I can understand as a politician. If I was running for Congress now, I'd be in panic. Because if the national, the president, vice president, senators are known, there go my watchers. Everybody's celebrating and I'm all alone with my opponent.
Very vulnerable.
That
if you have a manual
that happened
for the
to Monching Mitra. We got so mad. Poor guy is dead. But he was our candidate. And I don't know if you call it honesty, but he decided to concede immediately.
Yeah.
And we were so angry because what happens to the rest of us?
That's true.
So that's what will happen to the local candidates. They'll be abandoned by their watchers.
And also, in the blogosphere and internet, people saying, okay, maybe there will be no failure of elections, but maybe we should just delay the elections. May 10, maybe move it to another day, another...
I asked, I'm not an expert like Attorney Makalintal, and I said, what about this? And he said, yeah, I don't know what's the problem, but you need the law. It says, unless otherwise provided by law, it says, no, you don't. Because the law is made for the people, not the people for the law. Mm. And he said, if I was the Komalek and I feel I can't do it, I just postpone it a week. Who's going to go to the Supreme Court? Mm. He goes to the Supreme Court and say, we don't want elections anymore because it's delayed by 1 week. Mm. Supreme Court will throw that petition out. Mm. The Supreme Court will just say, I give you guys 1 week. You better do it because I don't know what sanctions we can impose.
Do you think Komalek will actually even think of the idea of delaying?
No. They're so conservative. I asked them, just ignore the law and allow the media to vote, absentee voting. Because who's going to challenge that? You want to get killed by the media?
True.
See who's going to go to the Supreme Court to challenge it. Mm.
They don't want.
All you need is a resolution.
Right.
And say, let's see who's going to attack the media on that.
We all got clobbered by this intra-chamber politics in the Senate, actually.
No, it that wasn't affected that. What happened was there was a Tining Martinez was won in the Supreme Court. He won over his opponent. The Supreme Court said he's the real winner. But he's the one who lost, was such a popular fellow that the House of Representatives refused to swear in the winner. Mm-hmm. And then, so every time the bill was presented, everybody would stand up and go to the South Lounge. Because she said, you know, it's
so
a nice
then there's no quorum. Yeah.
And to think, I said that I thought people win by the number of votes. Turns out it wins by popularity in the House. And that's true.
Okay. So you'll continually be in touch, obviously.
Yes. Wow. Like anything. I'll be sleeping there.
Until Friday. And yeah. Hopefully have the testing on May 7th.
Things I'd like to know is, I would like to know by tomorrow is where they will get the flashcards, locally or Taiwan. Okay. Taiwan is just a few hours away.
Sure.
They should be able to bring it here.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
I mean, these are the small.
All right. Many things, obviously, that the public has to be assured of.
Mm-hmm.
And hopefully all the explanations that have been provided by Comelec, Smartmatic, and Congressman Teddy Boy Locsin will somehow clear up this issue.
As I was telling you earlier, I said everybody has had a chance to frighten the living daylights out of the public. And I'm the one giving assurances. Can I scare them a little?
You know, yeah, well, sure.
What I want to say is that this is going to be a close-run thing. I think it's like Waterloo. Mm-hmm. We're the British, we're going to win, but it'll be close. Its success will be a close-run thing, but I think it'll work.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
There's going to be a lot of
Waterloo,
dead bodies along the way.
Just as long as it's not our Waterloo. It'll be our victory.
Not Little Bighorn like Custer.
Oh, yeah. All right. I have a joke about that. It's going to be said on TV.
It's not for TV.
All right. Congressman Teddy Boy Locsin, thank you very much for coming.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
We'll keep in touch with you, of course, as we wait for the configuration to be fixed by Smartmatic and Comelec.
And for our Waterloo.
All right, coming up next, technicians hired to oversee the Picos machines in Iloilo back out.
And a poll watchdog and a broadcasters group join forces.